guys, welcome to Akash Biology, and the topic that we'll be discussing today is the physiology of adrenal cortex. And in the previous video, we have dealt about the various actions of the mineralocorticoid. Now, in this video, we will be talking about the various actions and what are the hormones of the glucocorticoids. So, first of all, coming on to the glucocorticoids. As the name suggests, glucocorticoids have permissible action on the glucose metabolism. Which metabolism? Glucose. So it is mainly concerned with the metabolism of carbohydrate. And come to be more specific, it has more action on the metabolism of glucose. So what are those glucocorticoids mainly produced in our body? So they are cortisol, corticosterone, and cortisol. So these three are the glucocorticoid hormone that is being produced by the adrenal cortex in our body, and in which there is a more permissible action, and the major action among the glucocorticoid is of cortisol. That is about the 90% action is done by cortisol. Now, coming on to the functions of the glucocorticoid. So first of all, its function is on carbohydrate metabolism. So what it does? It will cause, as there is a muscles and there is liver and this is blood. Let's say blood, muscles and liver. So what it does? The muscles are mainly composed of the various proteins. So whenever there is secretions of the glucocorticoid, it will cause the breakdown of protein and the release of the protein in the form of amino acid in the blood. Amino acids. And these amino acids will go into the liver for the formations of glucose. So we can see there is breakdown of the protein in order to release the amino acids in the blood, and the amino acids will be forming glucose in the liver. So the gluconeogenesis process is undergoing in the liver, whereas there is a breakdown of protein, increase in the blood amino acids level. So in overall carbohydrate metabolism, the peripheral tissues are not getting the glucose. Even the peripheral tissues are being breaking down in order to providing glucose for the liver. Now coming on to the fat, again the adipocytes, there are lots of adipocytes in our body. So whenever there is secretions of the mineralocorticoids, the fat cells are again break down in order to release fatty acids. What? Fatty acids in blood. Now fatty acids will go into the liver for the formations of either glucose or any other substance for providing the energy. And if there is more of the secretions of the glucocorticoids, so these fatty acids are produced more in the blood, you know, with respect to the energy demand our body, so it will tend to form what? It will tend to form keto acids in our body. So whenever there is high secretions of the glucocorticoid, it will may lead to the formations of keto acids, and it is also known as a ketogenic hormone. So coming on to the actions of the glucocorticoid, so the carbohydrate metabolism is spared. So we are using mainly fats and proteins for the productions of energy, but glucose utilization is inhibited by glucocorticoids. So this is an effect of glucocorticoid and general metabolism. Now coming on to the second, it has also got actions on the bone. So it will mainly increase the osteoclastic activity. So if there is hyper secretions of the mineral glucocorticoid in our body, so it may lead to rickets in children or the irregular bone fractures. Coming on to the vascular response. The glucocorticoid or the cortisol will lead to increase in the concentrations or increase in the number of basophils snow fields, and then lymphocytes. Oh, sorry, it will tend to decrease the number of basophils, eosinophils, and lymphocytes, but it will increase the number of RBCs, platelets, and then neutrophils. Now, there is another on water metabolism. It will tends to accelerate the water excretion. So whenever there is a deficiency of glucocorticoids, so excess of water accumulations occurs in our body, may lead to the water intoxications. On to the mineral actions, it has same fate as the mineralocorticoids. So it will tends to cause increase in the sodium level, that is sodium retentions, whereas more potassium excretions. Then after that, coming on to the muscles, as we know, there is a breaking down of proteins of the muscles. So in hypersecretions of the glucocorticoid, severe muscle weakness and muscle wasting can occur. And then on central nervous system, it has got a permissive actions on the central nervous system, that is, it is needed for the proper functioning of the nervous system of our body. So whenever there is a hypersecretion or a hyposecretions of the glucocorticoids, there may be irritability, mental disability in the persons. Now coming on to permissive actions. So permissive is supporting actions. So it has got permissive actions, means the supporting action on calorigenic action of glucagon. Similarly, it has got the permissive action on the vasoconstrictive action of adrenaline and noradrenaline. Similarly, it is often needed for the lipolytic action, bronchodilator action of catecholamines. Now, this hormone is highly responsible for the resistance to stress. So whenever we are in often stress or any fight and flight response, so our body needs enough glucose. So at that time, in order to cope with that stress or in order to get rid of that stress, it provides resistance to that conditions. So what it causes the breakdown of proteins of the muscles, similarly breakdown of the fats in the adipose tissue in order to provide enough glucose in the liver and enough amino acids in the blood in order to form more glucose in the liver. Similarly, it has also got anti-allergic actions, anti-inflammation actions, and it is also needed in the it has got the immunosuppressive effect. So it will suppress our immune system. So we might get confused, what is this type of action? So this action is mainly needed or be useful in organ transplantations. When we do organ transplantation, there is a high chance of rejections of dead organs in our body. So we will mainly administer the glucocorticoid because it will tends to suppress our immune system, and that newly given organ, transplanted organ, will not be rejected from our body. Now coming on to the update of clinical physiology of this. So if there is, sorry, I have to see my notes. So hypersecretion of glucocorticoid, it will lead to a disease known as Cushing syndrome. So before going on to the detail of Cushing syndrome, let's just reveal all things. First of all, pituitary gland will secrete a hormone ACTH, and it will stimulate the adrenal cortex to secrete cortisol. So the Cushing syndrome. So hypersecretion of the cortisol can occur in the two cases. if there is a tumor or over secretion of the pituitary gland of ACTH, so it will stimulate the adrenal cortex more to secrete cortisol. Or in the second case, if there is tumor of the adrenal cortex, so it will produce more cortisol. So if there is a first case, that is the tumor of the pituitary gland leading to the over secretion of ACTH, then this case is known as Cushing's disease. But if there is problems or the pathology in the adrenal cortex leading to the hypersecretions of cortisol independent of the ACTH production, then it is known as Cushing syndrome. So what are the pathological features of the Cushing syndrome? In the Cushing syndrome, we can see moon face, erythematous appearance, similarly torso means a hump, torso and buffalo hump in the patients. Similarly, there is sebum muscle wasting, hyperglycemia, and there is overproduction of the ketone body in the patients. Similarly, there is irregular bone fractures, and there is more vascular response, the vasoconstrictions, that is high BP, and edematous appearance. So, Cushing syndrome. Now, lastly, coming on to the sex corticoids that is being secreted by the zona reticularis. So, sex corticoids. On the sex corticoids, it has two types: androgen and then female hormone, that is estrogens and progesterone. Among the androgen, there are testosterone, dihydroepiandrosterone, and then lastly, that is the androstenedione. So, the sex corticoids produced by the adrenal gland are mainly the androgens, and to a very less extent, there is only the estrogens and progesterone. Are being secreted in a very less amount. So coming on to the pathology of the sex corticoids. So whenever there is high secretions of the sex corticoids, so it will lead to a disease that is known as adrenogenital syndrome. So what happens in adrenogenital syndrome? There is hypersecretions of the adrenal sex corticoids. So in male and in female, it has got the two phases. In male, it will cause all the female characteristics, that is gynecomastia, atrophy of testes, infertility, and the loss of interest in woman. And a bit feminizations, means characteristics of feminizations. In female, it will cause atrophy of breast, deepening of voice. Similarly, there is amenorrhea, there is no menstruation cycles. And male type of hair growth, often known as adrenal virilism. And there's also the development of the male characteristics in female, that is the masculinizations in the female. So this all is about the physiology of adrenal cortex. If you this video is really helpful to you, then please like, and for more videos tap the subscribe button. Thank you.